Hello, this is CC Allen, and thank you for joining us today on the Good News Show. Listen, I have a special guest with us tonight, my dear brother, Delano Johnson. He is absolutely awesome. This man of God is a strategic strategist when it comes to creativity. He is absolutely awesome. He's a creative life and brand architect. And so today I want to talk to you about how to maximize God's hidden treasures in your buried talent. That's what we want to talk about today. And so in today's times, we know we're in what we call a pandemic. But I want you to understand something, that in the midst of tragedy, God has some hidden treasures inside of you that he wants to go digging for. He wants to bring out those treasures, but focus on the things that's going to bring out the greatness that lies within you. So he has some treasures in you that's going to be brought out during this session. And I want to give you some tips and tools, some strategies. And so God can use some things in you in this time, this season. There's a lot of things that was birthed during tragedy. A lot of things that was birthed during the time of famine. A lot of things that was birthed during strange times, during hard times. A lot of inventions, a lot of things that was going on. Businesses birthed during this time. And so I know some of you are going through. I know some of you are having a hard time. But I want you to dig into the greatness that lies within you. And so Delano Johnson is going to bring some things out, some tips and tools, some strategies to help you to dig in, to find that treasure that's within you. Now, some of you said, I don't have anything to give. I don't have anything. I don't have anything in my mind. I don't have anything creativity. I'm sure you do, but you have to have a strategist that can show you where the treasure is so you can go get it and pull it out. Today is that day. I want to bring to you my brother, Delano Johnson, who is going to help you do just that. Right after this commercial break, I want to bring to you the man of God who's going to help you find that treasure. Stay with us. Don't go nowhere. And tell somebody to tune in right now.
Kid old enough for money but too young to deal with a checking account? Oh, and you don't really want to deal with cash? You need the Cube Kid Card. Reload right from your bank account, set parameters, and spend just like a normal debit card. If the card is lost, no problem. Without the app, the balance is zero. Get yours at cubemoney.io.
Are you suffering from fear and anxiety? The Allen Counseling Clinic is here to help. Our goal is to help you grow from your struggles, heal from your pain, overcome your fears, and get the relief from your anxiety. Call now, area code 424-295-6227. Telehealth is now available.
City where there are more creative people per square mile than any other place on the planet. Question is, how many of them are successful? How many are just like I was, talented and broke? Being broke is more than just not having money. It's failure to turn opportunities into profitable businesses and relationships that last. My mother always said, people perish for lack of knowledge. A compass takes you in the direction of your destiny, but knowledge of obstacles and distractions will ensure you arrive safely. My mentor once said to me, if I had half your talent, I'd have four times my wealth. Since then, I made a promise to God. If he would help me unlock my earning potential, I would pay it forward and help others do the same. That's why I wrote this book. Because God made us too talented to live our lives broke. That includes you.
Hey, my brother, glad to have you on the show. I want to bring to this audience all over the world, my brother, Delano Johnson. How you doing, brother?
What's up, TC?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, man, it's been too long. Thank you for this invite. I am excited about the reason why I'm here, not just being here, but also the reason why I'm here today, man. It's great.
I appreciate it. As you know, during this pandemic, I started the Good News Show because I got tired of all the bad news that we were having, all the deaths that I'm hearing just about every day. And I know there is some good news out there. I know there are some people out there who's believing God, who has faith, and is pushing through this storm. And I know that there are several people out there that have some tips, tools, strategies, also some encouraging words to get to the people. And you are one of them, sir. So I thank you for being on the show.
Oh, man. Thank you. My pleasure, buddy.
Yes, sir. So first question, how are you doing during this pandemic? And I know you got family. I know you got businesses. And I know you speak all the time, all over the world. And so how are you handling this time, this pandemic?
Man, believe it or not, man, I'm more busy than the regular schedule. What this has done is caused people to really look deep within themselves and question or to actually create a few questions for themselves. Number one, am I being busy but not effective? Number two, why am I so busy? A friend of mine said to me the other day, Delano, I think I'm addicted to busyness. That's a bad thing to be addicted to. You want to be addicted to results. You want to be addicted to progress. You want to be addicted to purpose. And so I think what has happened is that a lot of things that I wanted to do but was too busy to do because I was inundated with clients and projects that needed to be completed. This time really gave me an opportunity to look at some of the things that God was telling me to do, and I was getting around to doing it, but this time forced it to happen. So number one, I'm grateful for the opportunity to have this time. It's unfortunate, number one, that it had to happen through this scenario. And then number two, the actual scenario in and of itself is a tragedy and a major crisis for all of us. But one thing I learned in life that out of every tragedy, there's some triumph waiting to be dug up, waiting to be had, waiting to be seized. In every crisis, there is an opportunity to be extremely creative. So those are the things that I'm focused on and that I'm most grateful for. Now, it's not to say that there are people who I know who have actually passed from COVID-19. So while it is extremely sad to see the result of this virus just wreaking havoc on the earth, there are some good things that come out of it. And so we know that life gives us good days and bad days, and we have to somehow figure out how to make the end of the year profitable, prosperous, and most importantly, in accordance to what God's purpose is for our lives. So my family is good. I have all praises to God for keeping my family safe, my immediate family, my kids, And my dad, who is 93 now, he's in the Bahamas. He's well and safe. My uncles, my brothers and sisters, I've spoken to many of them, and it's a lot of us. It's officially 27. Officially it's 50, and unofficially it's 27 kids.
That's a lot.
That's a big family. Yeah, and I just actually found out it was 27. If you read my book, I say that I'm 14 or 15 kids. I just found out that, you know, Papa was a real Rolling Stone. So there is some good things to come out. It's unlike with everything else. I mean, there you have to be able to find what the devil meant for good, how God will make it. I mean, what the devil meant for evil, how God will make it good.
Right.
How he would turn those things into good for your benefit. Scripture says that all things work together for good to them through criteria that love him and that is called according to him. Now, ain't no guarantees that all the things that happen to you is going to work out for your good if you don't fit that criteria, right? You got the stimulus package and there is criteria that has to be underlined. And if you don't meet those criteria, you don't get that $1,200. You don't get access to that loan. It's the same way. The criteria is, one, you got to be called according to his purpose, not your dreams and aspirations, but his purpose. And then number two, you got to love him. So that's how we convert every tragedy into some triumph and every crisis to some victory. Yeah.
Well, that's awesome, and I'm glad your family doing well during this pandemic, and I know you're in New York, where it's really hit hard, and I know you have a lot of friends and loved ones there in New York, and we're praying for you all. And so during this crisis, I just have some questions because how important is creativity during this crisis? How important is that?
Wow, that's a good question. You know, creativity is one of those words like love. When you have it, you know it. When you need it, you search for it. You don't necessarily know how to describe it. But when it comes to you, your life is totally different. Creativity is an extremely important word in the Bible. Matter of fact, it is the noun of that word that God first described himself as. In the beginning, God created. So he's first a creator. He's God first, then he's a creator. We use that law of first mention. So he's a creator, which means that if we are made in his image and his likeness, we have access to the same creativity that created the world. Now, to understand the gravity of that situation, all you gotta do is go outside. Look up, look at the clouds and how the clouds are suspended. The sky doesn't move. How the trees find nourishment from vitamin D in the sunlight and photosynthesis. And if you look at everything that God has created, there is a system to regenerate and to renew the world, to renew the landscape, to renew you, us, our bodies. I've heard somewhere that every 72 hours our body rejuvenates itself and our cells are made new. So this word create creativity is important because it is a part of who we are. The thing is, how do we embrace it and how do we use it? How do we call on it when the times that we need it most? And if there's ever a time that we need creativity, it's now. I want to point this out, that it is in crisis, it is in the middle of challenges, it is in the middle of what we call the three C's, where it is accelerated change, overwhelming complexities, and fierce competition. So that's the environment where creativity comes alive. Creativity is what I call the vitamin C to those three things: overwhelming complexities, accelerated change, and fierce competition. Now, that's from a business perspective. We're dealing now with another C, this coronavirus, this COVID-19. Again, there is creativity in the midst of crisis. This message is brought to you by the letter C, just in case you haven't really figured it out.
So my question is that during this crisis, COVID-19, how in the world can you be creative during the during the stressful time where you have a lot of anxiety, worry, doubt? How in the world do all of these things come out of certain tragedies?
Yeah. It all stems from, one, being grounded in your purpose. That's number one.
That's good.
You know, whenever something happened to Paul, he knew he had a benchmark, and that was, hold on, I'm in prison, but this isn't my final destination. I'm supposed to go to Rome. And he was shipwrecked. Another tragedy. Wait a minute. I have not yet. Wait. I hadn't gone to Rome yet, so I ain't finished. For Jesus, it was, he would say something in the temple, and the scribes and the Pharisees, they would get at him, and the Bible would say that he would move through the crowd and slip and disappear. And then the scripture would finish with, because it was not yet his time. He had a very keen and focused purpose. He knew that the cross was his destination and nothing else could take him out. If you are focused on your purpose, you ain't finished yet. You ain't done it yet. You ain't at that mark. You haven't reached your Rome yet. You know, number one, that there is still hope and time for you. So that's the moment when you, while everybody else is scrambling and trying to figure out what to do and trying to figure out what the future is, well, you know what your future is. You got to go to Rome. You got to get to the cross. You got to get to the place where God told you you would be. So that's what we focus on. So first we got to arrest fear by painting the picture continually of the end of what our purpose is and where it takes us. That's the first thing that we have to do. When you do that, you're going to find that your body will become more relaxed. You take and arrest the fear that we feel because of the unknown. We don't know what's going to happen. We don't know. Everybody's locked inside the house. So that will bring you to a place where now you can start to actually think. You can pray, but just don't speak to God. You start to listen.
Good. Because that's right.
It is in the listening that he whispers the secrets of your future. It is in listening that he whispers the secrets of your future. It is in listening. It comes by what? Seeing. No, it comes by hearing. So you would hear the things that you may have forgotten. I'm not in Rome yet. So now God grants you, because you're listening, the access to his creativity. To do what? Well, from a creative standpoint, many of you were given talents, right? God gave you 5, 6, 7 talents. Now is the time, because you're listening to God. We're talking about purpose. Stay with me now. Talking about purpose. Within that purpose, God gives you a theme. Within that theme, he gives you tools, which I call your talents. Your creativity is the power to solve the problems while using your talents on the road to your purpose. Your creativity is the ability to pull down ideas so that you can figure out how to use the tools of your talents on the road to your purpose. The challenge is, many of you don't even know how many talents you have. I'm going to ask you right now how many talents you have. And listen, I speak all over the world, and this is the first question I ask my audience, whether it's 5 people or 5,000. And I'm amazed at the fact that most people can't even list their talents. But if you understand the principle in Matthew 25, and this was one of the most important principles of stewardship and of what God expects from And I want to say this. This may shake your theology a little bit. God is not a giver. I want this to just sink in a little bit. We get this wrong, DC. God is not a giver. He is, matter of fact, when you give something for someone, you're not expecting anything in return. If I give you a present, I don't expect for you to give it back to me. I don't expect for you to give me something in return. I gave you a present, a gift, because you needed it. But this parable, Matthew 25, paints God in a totally different picture. And I want you to really get this. When God gives, he is expecting for the potential to be pulled out of whatever he gives you. When God gives, he is expecting for you to unearth the potential from whatever he gave you. So we call that in financial terminology an investor. So God is an investor. Why? Because he's looking for a return, the potential, the ROI, return on that investment. In other words, God will give you this. He'll give you seeds. He'll give you apple seed. He'll give you a mango seed if you're from the Caribbean like I am. He'll give you seeds to sow. But what he's looking back is for an orchard. He's looking for one apple. He's looking for an orchard. Why? Because in every seed, there is an orchard. It only took one man to populate the entire world and one woman to help him to do so. So God is giving you the seeds in this talent. The talents that he's giving you, these are seeds. Now let me tell you why God's an investor. Jesus tells the parable. Rich man was going away. Before he went away, he called three of his best guys. And he says, listen, I'm leaving, but I'm going to give you, number one, I'm going to give you five talents. I'm going to give you five talents.
Right.
I said, thank you, Master. On the second one, he said, listen, I'm going to give you two talents. And he called the third one and said, now, I'm going to give you one talent. Now, there's a disparity in the amount, but the scripture said that he gave it based on their ability.
Ability.
Ability for what? Ability for what? What ability is the master gauging the amount of what he gave to each servant? He's gauging their ability to return his investment. Now, the answer is in the way that they responded to the master when he returned. I'm going through this real quick for you. Because we're talking about what do you need to do during this time of crisis. I want to add a caveat here, just to make you shout. Ironically, the word crisis in Mandarin doesn't mean an issue that cannot be solved. It actually is two strokes, and it actually means observe and solve. Observe opportunity. Observe opportunity to solve. So no wonder why the whole world is out of masks and China's producing it. It's amazing to me that there's no respirators could be found around the world, but China cranking them out by the hour. God is giving you these talents. And here's what he's expecting. He's expecting you to double it. You say, well, Delano, what do you mean double?
How can we double in this time?
Yeah, how can you double in this time? First of all, a buddy of mine called me and said, Delano, you know anybody who needs some hand sanitizer? I said, hand sanitizer? I said, I'm good. I got it. He said, no, I'm selling it. You're selling hand sanitizer? He said, yeah. He said, I got about 500,000 gallons. What? 500,000? He said, I got access to 500,000 gallons. He said, do you know anybody? There is, first of all, what you got to understand is that the money supply, M1, M2 money supply, did not disappear because Corona came on the earth.
Right.
The money is still here.
Right, right. I mean, to just park right there for a minute And a lot of people think, you know, money is gone. Money is still flowing. Money still flows in ministry. Money still flows right in the midst of a pandemic, right in the midst of everything that's going on. I was just on a call earlier today where this deal that I am a part of, I don't want to say it online, but I'm saying it anyway because God gets the glory, is $400 million. And so, they're buying banks, they're shifting money, they're doing deals all around us, and we're waiting on a stimulus check. When God said, "Be creative and leverage the things that I gave you," and during this time, major money is moving. So, what are we waiting on? When the thing that God has given us is right in on the inside of us. And in some cases, it's right on our phone. It's right in our Rolodex. It's right in our plan for this year. But we're so afraid, scared, and fearful that we forgot what God told us before the storm.
Yeah. That's real good. I mean, listen, you have to look at this. Matter of fact, John D. Rockefeller said, "The best time to invest is when there's blood on the street."
Wow. Wow.
I want you to listen to that. The time to invest is when there's blood on the street. You say, well, that's demonic. Okay. Well, let me go to Joseph. Joseph had a dream, told Pharaoh what the dream is. Pharaoh said, "Oh, that's a great dream. You're in charge." Joseph, in the time of plenty, they gathered all of the resources, the grain. Here's what happened. Everybody else who was living in that plenty was lavish. They were spending like crazy, buying this, buying. Matter of fact, they was buying, you know, $5,000 purses and bags, and will even spend $50 or $500 on a coach, right? They were spending $5,000 on a coach bag and can't even spend $5 to get a business coach. So you learn how to duplicate that money, how to double that money. So what Joseph did was, when the time of plenty was done, the Bible say Egypt opened up her storehouse and became a wholesaler and retailer to all of the other neighboring towns and cities that was living life. So Joseph made money to Egypt in famine. During the famine,
right. So, where are the Joseph during this famine? I'm almost sure. I just got a phone with about five of them early today. And so there are people that got positioned during this time to be the Joseph of their family, to be the Joseph of their community, to be the Joseph of their state, their country, to bring resources to them where there was none.
Right. And let me just say this. It's, you know, we use the word money kind of frivolously, but I want to say it's really not about what the word we call money. It's really about power. Money is power reduced to paper. It is the ability, scripture says that the poor man has the answers for the nation, but no one will hear him. The rich man is a fool, but everybody listens. That money gives him certain power, resources that he commands. So when you have the resources, the power, when you speak, things happen. This is how the system of the world created, where it reduces your sovereign power, the power that God give you to speak things into existence. Before you can see it in existence, it usually comes through the passage of some type of monetary currency. You can still speak these things and you can still get resources without it going through currency. But this is the order of the day. And so it's up to you to look at Matthew chapter 25. I said to you have to double what God gave you. First of all, you have to know how many talents you have, because it is expected And whatever God gives you, the talent, to double it. Whatever talents he's given you, you have to double that. There's a whole process I go through with really understanding that. And herein lies a lot of the reasons why we don't have the Joseph, DC. Because they haven't done the homework in understanding how to convert creativity into cash flow and contracts. How to create, to convert time into treasure. I always say that there's only five real currencies, and I'm skipping it. I got to make these connections with the dots here. You got five currencies. You got time, talent, you got ideas, you got creativity, and you got relationships. That's the five currencies that you actually have. That's your real hardcore God-given value and currency. So right now you have some talents. God gave you however many he gave you. It's up to you to know how much. Because when the master returned, the one who had five said, "Master, you gave me five. You're a hard man. You're an investor. So I'm giving you back 10. The response of the master was extremely awesome, fascinating. He said, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Well done, why? Because he converted something that was given to him from potential to actual." So obviously God knew that he gave him 10, but it was hidden in 5. God gave you this talent of writing, gave you this talent to speak. God gave you this talent to reason. God gave you the talent to prognosticate, to know the future, to be able to determine what the wind will be tomorrow. Gift of prophecy. But you haven't used it. Or the gift that is needed in this time, you buried.
Wow.
Because it wasn't a glory gift.
Wow. Wow. So you're saying the gift that God gave you during this time is needed during this time, but you buried it.
Listen, I do CPS training. I do corporate CPS training and personal CPS training. CPS training is creative problem solving. I have actors, I have entrepreneurs, entertainers, athletes that I consult. People who depend on their creativity for high performance, particularly CEOs and entrepreneurs. I had one guy, a client who's an actor, said to me, "Delano, I am nervous about the future." I said, "Why is this?" He said, "Because I've only ever focused on acting. That's the thing I set out. My grandfather told me to don't be the jack of all trades and master of none, right?" He said, "To focus on one thing," and I just shook my head. You know, times change. If you're not multifaceted, multiverse, multi-talented, you can multitask. Guess what? You're obsolete. In order for businesses to be competitive, they have to be multinational corporations. So that talent that you used before COVID-19, you're finding out that it could be obsolete. I wouldn't say that it's obsolete yet, but that's still to be determined. However, there are some talents that you buried. Why? Because you focused on the glory talent, right? The stuff that people see when you get instant gratification. You get the applause and the notifications and you get the notoriety. You get that. But there's some talents that's needed in this time. God gave it to you actually for this time and period. In the 1600s, the bubonic plague. I studied this because I wanted to look for models of what to expect. There was no plague that affected humanity like this bubonic plague. And they didn't have the technology to detect and didn't even know what it was, that it was
right.
Flee from rodents. So what I'm seeing now is that your talent that you buried must be doubled. So you're behind the eight ball because you let that rot. You let it decay. You let it dissipate. But it could be revived. could be revived. And now is the time, because you're listening. Again, you have a sense of purpose. You focused on your purpose. Now you're listening to God as He whispers to you, and He's going to whisper you. And I even feel right now He's whispering to some of you, even as I said that. The Holy Spirit brought to you is the talent that I've been telling you that you need right
now. You said it's buried, but mm-hmm. you're about to dig it up, because it's needed during this time.
It is needed. Listen, I come to give you a shovel so that you can unearth that talent. We're talking about $400 million deals, or we're talking about $20 million deals. Listen, I'm as busy, I'm more busy than I was before COVID-19. How is that? Because I'm focused on the 5 talents God gives me. And now I got a head start. But it is not too late for you. I'm going to give you the shovel. Tell you that there's a way that you can unearth that talent. Yeah, you got to go and you got to relearn some things. You got to grab. You got to go on Google. You may have to go to YouTube University and find some stuff out about that talent that you got to dig up. But I'm telling you right now, the master hasn't returned. So there's still time for you to actually dig that up and to use it so you could command the resources and you could be a blessing to your family and your neighbors. You could be the one to help them. Somebody in your neighborhood right now don't know what they're going to do tomorrow because they don't have any more money. They don't know what to do. Family members died and they're discouraged.
Right.
Maybe when you use that talent, God will show you where the hidden treasures is from that buried talent. He'll show you where the hidden treasures are. And I know we're saying this here. I know you may still be saying, how? I'm telling you how. Listen. There's no 4 and 7 steps to success. This is you listening and God giving you the exact same things to do, but you have to first listen. We'll give you number 2. It's amazing. The servant who had 5, he doubled it, gave the master back 10. One who had 2, he doubled that, gave the master back 4. There's a pattern here. And after every time when they gave it back, doubled, the master always said, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of your master, your employer. I have given you little, now I will give you much." Why? Because you know and you've learned how to double my investment. Now, the one who had 1, very interesting. PC, this was very interesting. I tried to figure out the mentality of this one. And it always bugged me as a kid, hearing the scripture over and over. If you bury the 1 talent and you give God that 1 talent back, He's going to say to you, "You are wicked," which means indolent or lazy. It doesn't mean evil. But it means that you were lazy or you neglected the responsibility to unearth it. Again, God will tell you, "I will give you a land flowing with milk and honey." But here's how He thinks as an investor. He says, "I'm showing you this land with milk and honey." Ooh, I just got in my spirit. That's why you can't see the talent. Because He promised you milk and honey. But then He took you to a land where there is bees and cows.
Right. Like he took the children of Israel to a land. They spied it out. They came back with the grapes from the land. They said, "We are not able to overtake the land because there are giants in the land." He took them to the land, but it just had giants in it.
And you got to understand, an investor invests in your ability to turn his investment into a return for him.
But the thing is that Caleb and Joshua, said, we are able to take the land. The rest was like, no, we're not. We're as grasshoppers in their sight. So in their own sight, they saw themselves as small. They didn't even have a conversation with the enemy. They said what the enemy, they spoke for the enemy to themselves. And so when you're in fear, you speak for the enemy and defeat yourself. But God took you to the land to overcome the land, overtake the land, and you are well able to do it. You thought that when you came to this point, this pandemic, that everything will be handed to you. But God said, no, I gave you the ability to overcome, overtake, overthrow, and have dominion.
And that's exactly what you have to, as you spy and you look on that land. Yes, you are seeing that there are giants, but you can't see the view or the vantage point of the giant looking at you. So, number one, he takes you to a land of bees and cows when he promised you milk and honey, which means that you got to get the milk out of the cow and you got to get the honey out of the bees. Because you mistook the environment that God has you in, you didn't understand the conversion opportunity that's actually before you. With one, two, or maybe all of the talents that you have buried.
I'm sorry. You said they didn't understand the conversion opportunity. Don't just walk over that. Stay right there and talk about that. What you mean by that?
So I have Forex. I have money. Mm-hmm. Different currency. Well, in order to use that, I have to convert it to the other currency.
Right.
So I have fishes that I want to sell, but I have to take it to the market, and in order to get a tender, a legal tender that I can use for trade, because I can only carry that fish around for so long before it starts to rot. So I trade it for someone who needs to eat it right now, and I take a representation, what we call a conversion of value. So there's a value to the person who is hungry that buys the fish. There's a value to me that's frozen in time in that currency. So I take that and I'm able to buy whatever it is that I need. So God gives you a talent. Now, I got to break it down because we're talking about conversion. Now, I hold gold. You'd be a fool not to hold gold at all in this, in any economy. Because gold is the intrinsic value for every currency. Besides the workforce or the gross domestic product, in which a lot of fiat currency is backed by the ability for that country to turn exports and the employment power, but that's a whole other story. I want to deal with this word talent because we're talking about conversion. You didn't see or cannot see right now the opportunity for conversion from the bees extracting honey and from the cows extracting milk. So the word talent in this scripture, Matthew 25, is a word talentum. It means a measure of gold. A measure of gold. So the master gave them a measure of gold. Ironically, though, the word talent is the same word. It is a Greek word, but it's the same word for that we use in modern English and in our modern times as congenital abilities, giftings that you have, things that you can do, abilities, aptitudes, skills. These are your talents. But there is a dollar amount. The scripture was very clear on this, and a lot of people miss this. But if I convert a measure of gold, because this is exactly, and the Bible says it was a talent, so he gave them a talent. Hashtag a measure of gold. So let's convert that into today's gold. First of all, a talent is about, in today's measurement, 150 pounds of gold. 150 pounds of gold. Oh my God, I get ready to jump on this screen by myself. Now, it was a parable. A parable means a truth that is wrapped up in a simple story. The truth is, he gave you 150 pounds of gold in one talent. So the guy who had two talents was actually given 300 pounds of gold. Now let's convert that. 150 pounds if you trade in gold, we're about $15 or so. Was it $16 the last time I checked? It's about $15.89 or something. You can go and check. Approximately per troy ounce, this is $1,500. Just give you a round figure, $1,500 per troy ounce. We're looking at approximately $1.35 million. That's the conversion of the talent. See, it takes work to get to that beehive. You're going to get sting, but you got to do the work to extract the honey from the bee so that you can have some value, whether it's to eat or to sell.
What you're saying is that you're going to get there and you have the talent to do the work.
Yeah.
It's not going to be handed to you. You got to get to work.
No. No, the work is the effort. The talent is the skill. The work is the effort to convert that skill into value. So you can sing. Well, I can sing right now. The Lord is, but I ain't making no money from that. I've used the skill, but my ability to find a way to identify people who need some inspiration through my singing and charge them a premium. Why? Because I do it and I do it well. I perfected the art of my skill. I perfected my craft. So now I can command top dollar. If God give your neighbor a land full of milk and honey, and you know how to get honey, guess what? Now you can charge your neighbor, because God gave him the promise of a land full of milk and honey, but he's stuck with bees and cows. You can say to your neighbor, listen, I know how to get honey from bees. That's a skill. That's a talent. So your job, you got to go down the list here because I know we're covering a lot. And we and TC getting excited all by ourselves.
Right.
The amen section. But first, during this pandemic, you have to focus on your purpose. It's your purpose. What did God say to you? What did he say that you would accomplish? What you got to focus on. When you focus on that, like Paul did when he was, it was nerve-wracking to be in a wreck, but he remembered his purpose. I got to go to Rome. So you have to remember so that the fear subsides. And when the fear subsides, you're able to now hear. Faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. So now you got faith. Now you got faith enough to believe, right, that the talents he's given you could be relevant in this market. Now God starts to call the opportunities towards you. Listen, there are people that I never thought I would be talking to, let alone giving advice to, that's calling me. Whatever it is that you have to do, you go down that line, you would find the faith to be able to create the fortune within your talent, within your talents, and specifically the one or the ones that you buried. We're talking about finding God's hidden treasures in your hidden talent, in your buried talent, rather. So when you come to that place where now you've identified the talent, you may have to brush it off and polish it up. Now you're ready to take that to market. Now you're dealing with the modern mediums. Right now, everything is on the internet. I'm talking to you. I would have been talking to you on a stage, but we're adjusting. The word still goes forth. We're adjusting. So you don't have to leave the convenience of your house, even though you want to right now.
Right.
but you can. But God is bringing this message directly to you where you are and telling you that there is hidden treasure in your buried talent. And TC has made it possible for you to actually hear this message today.
And that's absolutely awesome, because there's a lot of things that people can do during this time, but they chilling and watching Netflix, they're eating and everything else. But during this time, me and my family are the most busy than we ever been, you know, before the pandemic. And so,
I want to say this, TC. I want to just say this. It's in your best interest if you're listening right now, because some people are addicted to work. They're addicted to busyness. And I think a lot of us were slapped in the face with that reality. I only want you to be busy after finding the passion for that purpose again. And then you'll be able to see a passion at different levels where God will start to make provisions. He will start to help you to perfect that talent so that now you can put it on the shelf, the digital shelf of the marketplace, and be able to receive top dollar for your effort. So you shouldn't be watching Netflix. You should be trying to figure out how to create content, because Netflix is running out of content. Hulu is running out of content. That is an opportunity. That is some milk being extracted from cows. If you're a writer, if you're a producer, you got a creative, you're in the creative arts, you should be looking for opportunities to create content.
Right.
So don't just be busy, be effective.
That's powerful. I want you to give me the five things that we can use gifting wise. What was those five things again?
So we're talking about your intrinsic currencies.
Yes,
that
sir.
Done. So your time, your talent, your ideas, creativity, and your relationships. Again, your time, talent, ideas, your creativity, and your relationships. You may not have money, but if you understand how to use those five things, you're the richest man or woman in the world.
Very, very wealthy. Well, my brother, that's our time, but stay with us.
Because Jericho. Who's that again? Joshua.
Joshua, yeah.
Joshua. Listen, son, we ain't finished this battle yet. You gotta stand still. We ain't finished this battle yet.
We're not done, but I'm gonna take a commercial break. And we're going to come back, and we're going to wrap up when we come back. But I want you to stay with us, because there are some people out there that's hurting really bad. And I know some of them personally. And they're saying that, like the woman who the prophet asked, what do you have in your house? She said, I don't have anything but a jar of oil. And he said, go get that jar of oil. And so what is that very thing that I can do right now to sustain me and my family during this time, during this famine? My clients are going through, my business is going through. So what can I do during this time to sustain me? Stay right there. We'll be right back. So I want you, don't go anywhere. My good friend, my good brother is going to wrap up in one minute. And he's given us some tips and twos and some strategies to help us realize the greatness that lies within us, that treasure that God wants to use in this time, in this pandemic. There's many people who's been very, very creative. They're creating masks during this time to cover your face. They're creating different things, hand sanitizer with certain elements around the house. They're very creative during this time, but you can birth out a book during this time. Birth out of business during this time. What can you give birth to during this time is what I want you to focus on. Don't focus on the negative news. Focus on those who are dying during this time. it's unfortunate that we're going through this time, but what are you going to give birth to when we come out? What's going to come forth when we come out? And so this is your time. This is your season. You're locked in the house. You don't have anything to do but focus on that, what God has given you, what God has birthed into you, what God has, the word is, invested in you, and he wants a return. And the return is going to come right now. During this time, what are we going to bring forth? Focus on that. We'll be right back with my good friend, Mr. Johnson, who has been phenomenal. And so, listen, don't go nowhere. Stay right there. We'll be right back.
Kid old enough for money but too young to deal with a checking account? Oh, and you don't really want to deal with cash? You need the Cube Kid Card. Reload right from your bank account, set parameters, and spend just like a normal debit card. If the card is lost, no problem. Without the app, the balance is zero. Get yours at cubemoney.io.
Are you suffering from fear and anxiety? The Allen Counseling Clinic is here to help. Our goal is to help you grow from your struggles, heal from your pain, overcome your fears, and get the relief from your anxiety. Call now, area code 424-295-6227. Telehealth is now available.
Delano A. Johnson here, author of the new book, Talented and Broke. That is going to be on Monroe Press. Every major turn in your life, you have to go and see the Godfather. You have to go and see your mentor. Buddy, I want you to be introduced to my mentor, Dr. Miles Monroe.
Hi, y'all. This is a very unique moment, because Delano is here with me in my home study in my house in the Bahamas.
Yeah.
And he's been spending the last 4 hours with me here chatting about some visionary items. Very excited about the future. And of course, I'm excited about his new project. Fantastic book here, Talented and Broke. And of course, I think you all need to make a pledge right now that you are not going to live talented and broke. And I promise you, this book is going to change the way you think. Thanks again for being a part of our secret private thinking tank here in the Bahamas. God bless you, and I'll see you at the top.
Hey, and as always, embrace your creativity. Goodbye, guys.
And welcome back. My brother, that was a clip that I know personally, because you shared a story with me. None other than the late Dr. Miles Monroe is not only your mentor, but your spiritual father. And if anything, I know he taught you kingdom. And he promoted the book, Refuse to Be Talented and Broke During This Time. And so before he went home to be with the Lord. Now, share with us how that relationship affected everything concerning the book, that relationship really launched things to be different in your life, and the tips and tools you learned from Dr. Miles Monroe.
Yeah, man, it's, you know, I started going to the church when I was 18. I grew up in church, 17, sorry. Yeah, around there. I was, you know, the youth grew up in the church and started traveling with him. We had a music group. We did Christian rap. And he would take us on the road with him.
I got a pause right there. You mean you could? I know you from New York, and so you got KRS-One, you got Run DMC, you got all the greats. You know, it started right there in the Bronx. But you mean tell me you could flow? Come on now.
Hey, listen, we did. If this was when, you know, Christian rap wasn't even big yet, right? And we blended it with reggae, so we were totally unique. It was me and my two guys, Kevin Harris and Tunia Thompson. I was the singer, and they were the two rappers, and we traveled with him. He took us on the road before he took the Praise group.
Wow.
On the road.
Wow.
It was because of him we were on TBN. We were traveling with him. And it was just, it was amazing that everybody else was traveling with the psalmist who was singing, you know, praise and worship music. But he saw that what we were doing was praise and worship music, but just for our generation. And I'm telling you, that in and of itself, all of the nuggets of, he would tell me, say, watch me now, I'm going to go on stage. I'm going to present this word, but I want you to watch not only what I say, but I want you to watch how I say it. And he would tell me this, because I was the one to do the exhortation before we sang and ministered. And he would tell me, there's a teacher in you. You say that. You got the teaching gift, son. You got the teaching gift. He said that. And so he taught me some things, man, that I hold dear, and I think it's the foundation of why I'm so successful in public speaking, inspirational speaking. Things that I've learned from him has just taken me just so far. But it was because of his endorsement, and I'll never forget. That video was actually 3 days before the plane crash.
Wow.
We were actually together. He said 4 hours, and we recorded that video around a little bit after 4 hours. But I was there for almost 8 hours in that meeting, and that was the longest time I'd spent with him on a one-on-one, just me and him. The only other time was about 4 hours when I was about 18, And we talked about everything. We talked about the book. And it was then that we were supposed to actually tour in 2015. And there were some things that I wanted to do for him, because he was at the place where I thought that he could have his own publishing company. And right there and then, we created Monroe Press. And in that meeting, we designed the logo. He's also an artist, and we designed the logo right there.
Wow.
Yeah, right there. And if you have a copy of my book, you'll see the Monroe Press is on there. And so, and we did that long enough where his son came in and told him, hey, this is where we changed the name of the publishing company. If you have a Miles Monroe book, you probably would see Diplomat Press on there. And just the story of how that happened, man. It's just the story of how it happened. I'm going to give you the short version of it. We out of time? Or are we good?
Give me the short version, because we talk about the late Dr. Miles Monroe. I think we got time for him.
Okay. Well, so I asked him to do the foreword for the book. He said, great. It was in February of 2014 when I sent him the manuscript. And he said, listen, I'm going to be done with this. I'm going to be in Jersey. Come up and spend some time with me. I said, oh, good. So he was in New Jersey. I rode down. And he said to me, after he was finished ministering that night, we were out in the lobby. And he said to me, this book is great. And he started to go through some of the chapters. So I knew he read all the way through, because we stopped on chapter 7. He was talking about chapter 7, which is chapter 7 deals with the seventh reason why you may be talented and broke is because your creativity is poisoned by toxic relationships.
Right.
And we talked then about the hardship in the relationship that I had, my marriage, getting divorced and everything. And so he said, listen, this book is, he said, do you have a publisher? I said, no. I said, I don't have a publisher. He said, you have one now. I'm sending this to my publisher. They're going to publish it, and you're going to travel with me, and we're going to push this book. And I was ecstatic. I was like, whoa. I mean, I wasn't anticipating that. And so I went home back, you know, he left. I went home. He said, send me the manuscript. I want to get it to my publishers. So one week go by, 2 weeks go by, a month goes by, 2 months goes by. I didn't send him the manuscript. And I'm procrastinating, and I'm trying to figure, wait a minute, I got the chance of a lifetime. Why in the world am I, what's happening here? And so I went to bed this specific night, had a dream. And the dream was cast into the past where I was about 16, 17, and he was giving the church the vision. Part of the vision was a publishing company, again, Diplomat Press, which purpose was to publish the voices of the unheard.
That's good.
So I got up that morning and I'm like, oh, what is this? So I called him, pick up the phone. I said, Dad, I said, what's up with Diplomat Press? I said, what are you doing with that? I said, have you published anybody? Who have you published? I said, I remember specifically when I was a teenager, you said that the purpose of that was to publish the voices of the unheard. My pastor, who ain't shy for words and who always got more words than the norm.
Right.
He was silent on the phone. And this is what he said after I said that. He said, boy, you trying to send me to my early grave. This is the last part of my vision I want to get accomplished. He said, what do you have? What are you thinking? He said, matter of fact, I'm getting ready to go on the plane. Send me an email of your thoughts. So I sent him my thoughts and I basically said, Dad, you got a network that's global. I said, you got more books than people could read. You got over 75 titles.
Right.
I said, let me do what I do. I'm going to rebrand something. I said, there's messages that people don't know of. I said, let's get these stuff rebranded and repurposed and send them out. And I said, let's go ahead and let's find authors so that we can do what you said to do. Now, here's what God gave me. We had a meeting, and that same meeting there, that was scheduled for November the 3rd. That's when it was scheduled for. And then he got tied up because he was away for a whole month. So Wednesday I called him, and he said, I got to go for this interview. Thursday he called me and said, I am free. You better get in now before they come and arrest me and take me to go on some interview or something. And so I sped down there, and that was the beginning of that meeting. So while I was going there, God said to me, and I've never shared this with anybody, but he said to me, he said, because you've spoken his heart, he said, many wanted his anointing and carried his bide, but they didn't carry the Spirit. The anointing is not in carrying someone's bag, per se, but it is carrying their spirit, the passion that they have, why they have that passion. And so in that meeting is when I laid out a whole plan and said, this is how we're going to do it. You know, my background is brand architecture, publishing, I've done this, design books, strategics, and I need to buy them. I've designed books for Harper Collins, I've designed books, this, so I'm like, this is, you know, I can do this, this is my background. So I said to him, that's the plan, now all you have to do is make some calls. And he said, you know what, this is what we're going to do. Matter of fact, let's make your book the first book on the publishing company.
Wow. So he said, let's make your book the first book on Monroe's
Press. The first book on Monroe Press.
Wow.
Now, had he not said that, and had his own flesh and blood, his son, come in that meeting, that would have been said there, and it would have died there. Because after the king died, everybody won't be prince. Everybody won't be king, right? So, but God had it fixed so that there was a witness to his will. There was a witness for what he wanted. And so I took that man that same video, actually, when he said he wanted to record and endorse the book, I didn't even ask him to do it. But he's competitive. I told him about some other celebrity that endorsed it. And he said, oh, say no, you need my endorsement. Come on. So he said, you got to know my dad, man. My pops. So he said, come on, record me. So my phone was on E. I didn't know it, but I started recording, and then I saw that it was starting to blink. And in the middle of his endorsement, the phone cut off. I was like, oh gosh, and he was on the roll, so I didn't want to, so I just kept holding the camera. I'm like, yeah, I'll get it when we go, you know, on Sunday. I said, I'll get him when we go on Sunday. And I was done. Now, I'm thinking, I don't know if you realize that when you're recording and your battery goes off while you're recording, it doesn't save the video.
No.
So, Sunday comes around. I'm designing a brochure because he wants to make the big announcement of Monroe Press at the conference that he never made it to. So I'm there, he's going there. I got all of the graphics done. I have all that stuff done. We're ready to go. And he says that this is going to be good. This is going to be good. We're going to tour 2015. And I said, Dad, I said, you promote the book. I promote the publishing company. I say, I'll get the authors. I'll get them in. I said, all you do is you promote the book. And he said, that's exactly what I'm going to do. He got on the phone and he called. Matter of fact, he just gotten a royalty check. And he said, open this. I open it up. I'm like, whoa. He said, boy, he said, I'm going to show you how to make $1 million in 3 months.
From your book.
From my book. From the book. So.
Now, how many people do you know, other than the late Dr. Miles Monroe, that would share secrets with you like that?
Listen, you have to know him to understand the gravity of that, and how much he gave of himself. When Sunday came, I was getting ready to go, and that's a whole other thing. I was supposed to be on that plane because I was in the meeting and heard everybody who was going and then changed their mind, including his son, Charles Miles Jr., who made a decision that day that he was going to go over on that Thursday instead of going legal with him on that Sunday. His sister was already there. But I was there when his sister called from Freeport, where the conference was going to be held, and they had a conversation about some particulars with the conference. They worked in the ministry and helping. But he decided to go over. There was two more seats left. Mm-hmm. And I kept saying to myself, Delano, don't forget to ask the question. But we got wrapped up in talking about everything, and we were excited like kids, you know, playing and you know, in a sandbox. You know, he's an artist, so he's very passionate about art. And he was all in with designing the logo, man. So on that Sunday when I got the news, immediately God said, look at your phone.
Wow.
I looked at my phone, I turned it on, I hit the photos button. And up popped his whole video. It was actually two parts. It was actually two parts of that video that I edited to make it short. The first one got cut, and then I don't know, the phone somehow had power again, but I thought it cut off. But I know I couldn't use it afterwards, and I was sure that I didn't get that video. But when I turned on the phone,
it was there.
Video.
Wow.
And that was his gift to me, man.
Wow.
That was the last book that he endorsed. And that video is the last video of him. Usually on Sundays you have a video of his service, but all the equipment was sent from Nassau, where the church was, to where the conference was going to be held on another island in the Bahamas, Freeport. So all the video equipment was already sent. And so that's the last video of him. No, there's no other video in terms of the last video. So for me to hold that gift is, I got to do something. I got to get to Rome, right? I got to get to Rome. And for those out there who who's struggling with that talent, listen, I want to do this, if I can do this. If you're struggling with that talent, we don't have the time, but if you text creativity to 883-977-2167, that's text the word creativity to the number 833-977-4167. I want to help give you the four steps that you can actually do. This is empirical data using the law of deduction to help you find what that talent is. But I'm going to take you through the inventory stage, the networking stage, finding the opportunity stage, and then also, which is using your intuitiveness, your prophetic gift. Everyone has that gift. And then number four, using creative collaboration to bring that talent out. Creative collaboration is how you're going to get it done in this time and the season. Networking with like-minded people who have similar connecting talents, right? You saying they play the piano. You're going to find different people in business to do that. I'm going to show you, walk you through how to make that happen. That's, again, text creativity, the word creativity, to 833-977-2167.
Powerful. Powerful, man of God.
Thanks.
I thank you for your time, but you're not done yet, sir. No one can come to the show without praying for the audience. And so everyone that comes on the show has to pray for the area in which they minister to the people for.
Yes.
I want you to pray for the people to be creative during this time, that their ingenious will awaken, that their gifts will not lie dormant, but their gifts will come to the forefront. I want you to pray that the greatness that lies dormant within them will begin to rise. I want you to begin to pray that God will awaken them during this time, this season, and that they will prosper even as their soul prosper. To realize how wealthy they are, even though they may not have what we call money. But they have something that's better than money, and that's purpose. And their purpose will bring them before a great man. And I want you to pray in that vein as the Lord leads you. So I'm going to take a quick commercial break. And right when we come, the camera is going to come back on you. And when it comes back on you, just begin to pray as the Lord leads you. And so, my beloved, I thank you for hanging with your boy today. I have my dear brother, Delano Johnson. He is a jewel to the kingdom. And so he's also the spiritual son of the late Dr. Miles Monroe. And his book, Refuse to Be Talented and Broke, is a bestseller. And I want you to get that book, because that book is phenomenal. It will give you tips, tools, and keys that will help you grow, and that will help you find the treasure that God has within you. And so I want you to stop watching Netflix and scrolling through the movies, and get something that's going to help bring some things to the forefront, help you give birth to the next great invention, help you give birth to that business, help you decide what to do with that stimulus check you just got, and to give birth to something that's going to change the world. And so the thing is not, don't strive just to be different, but I want you to strive to make a difference in this time, this season. And what's going to make the difference is that talent, that gift, that anointing that is buried within you. It's time to bring it forth, time to bring it out. So now's your time, now's your season. Stay with us, because my brother is going to pray for us as we close this session out, this series out today, about how to maximize the hidden treasures that is buried within you. That's buried, but he's going to pray that God brings it out. And you have the boldness to go forth, to go forth in boldness to do what God has chosen you and purposed you to do. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Kid old enough for money but too young to deal with a checking account? Oh, and you don't really want to deal with cash? You need the Cube Kid Card. Reload right from your bank account, set parameters, and spend just like a normal debit card. If the card is lost, no problem. Without the app, the balance is zero. Get yours at cubemoney.io.
Are you suffering from fear and anxiety? The Allen Counseling Clinic is here to help. Our goal is to help you grow from your struggles, heal from your pain, overcome your fears, and get the relief from your anxiety. Call now, area code 424-295-6227. Telehealth is now available.
Heavenly Father, we just come before you today. God, we know that you care for us. You are concerned about everyone that's watching. You're concerned about the world, Father. Lord, I pray right now, specifically for those who are watching, you call them to greatness. You call them for such a time like this to show the glory of your kingdom. There is buried treasures in their talent. I thank you right now, Lord, that your Holy Spirit will begin to tell them and whisper in their ear the things that they have buried, so that you may help them unearth it, Father, and put it on the marketplace so that they may command resources to establish your kingdom for your honor and for your glory. Lord, I thank you right now for those that have talents and gifts that and they don't even know how gifted they are. They don't really know how talented they are, but Lord, that your Holy Spirit, as you send or help to send stimulus checks, then Lord, you would stimulate their creativity so that they can create revenue streams, so that they can create income. They can convert their creativity into cash flow, then Lord. They can convert their talents into treasure, their ideas into invoices. Father, I thank you right now, their relationships into royalties and residuals. Father, I thank you right now. I claim it for every person that's watching. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we know that in famine, there is opportunity. We know that in crisis, Lord, that there is opportunity. So I pray right now that your Holy Spirit give them the whisper in their ear and show them where the opportunities are. These things we ask in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray so let it be written and so let it be done. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Well, thank you so much, my brother. I want you real quickly to tell us how we can get a hold of you and how we can connect with you. And is there anything you have coming up that you want the people to tune into?
Yeah, I want them to, if they text creativity to 833-977-2167, they'll be able to talk directly to me. I respond to that directly. It's my text number, so you'll be able to text me back and forth. And also, I am we're getting ready to conduct a massive virtual live seminar where I'm going to walk through the book. There's a lot of things that we said about, you know, getting your creativity back into that place where you can start to command residuals and income and converting your creativity into cash. But I'm going to actually show you how to do that. I'm going to show you some of the things that you've allowed to hinder you from doing that, some of the reasons why you may have buried that so that those reasons are extracted from your life. And we're going to do that if you just text creativity to 833-977-2167. If you do that, then you'll actually get a discount on the book. So you can either get the actual physical book, which doubles as a workbook, or you can have the digital book. So you will get a discount if you text creativity to 833-977-2167. Or if you just want the book right ahead, right now, you can just go ahead to talentedandbroke.com or my name on the screen, which is DelanoJohnson.com. And it'll take you right to the site where you can actually get a copy of that best-selling book.
Well, thank you, my brother. And I want you to please go and get the book. The book is phenomenal. I have one. I bought one for my son, too, as well. And he loves it. And I like the idea of making sure that you tap into your creativity because now is the time for the creatives to come forth. And so thank you, sir, for your time. Thank you, sir, for your expertise and your wisdom and your encouraging words. And thank you for praying for us.
I want to leave one more quote for you. And just got it in my spirit.
Yes, sir.
Listen, this is really good. The future belongs to them that create it. And they are those who will receive the residuals and the royalties thereof.
Whew.
Let that sink.
Well, that said, we're going to end on that note, because in this time, the royalties are going to come to those who create. So
That's it.
That's powerful. Thank you so much for your time. I will talk to you soon. We got to do this again. And so, guys, bless you. And so, guys, listen, I want you to get that book from my brother. Go and get the book and go to Talented and Broke, or go to DelanoJohnson.com, and you can get the book. And we're going to put on the screen the number that he gave out, to text the number. And so when this plays, and so I want you to make sure that you connect with him, because he is absolutely phenomenal. And we didn't get into a lot of things that he's involved in, but I'm sure that when you connect with him, he will go some things and be able to help you in your business, in your personal finances, in things that that is lying dormant in you. He's a strategist, architect, that will pull some things out of you that you didn't know was in you. And so this is the time, this season, for the creators to rise. And so I want this show today to really give you a different perspective on how to look at certain things when you're going through. The woman who had nothing but a jar of oil was going through a famine in that time. And matter of fact, the people was coming to get, the creditors were coming to get her sons to pay the debt. And so I want you to understand the things that is going on within your household, what's going on around you. God has enough within you to sustain you. God has enough resources around you. God has enough people that you're connected to. God has some things that you haven't even thought of. And so I want you to send this video to someone, send this feed to someone who you know is going through during this time of season, and they feel or they think they don't have anything left in their household, anything left to give, anything left that they can do to make things happen. But don't worry about trying to be different. I want you to worry about trying to make a difference. If you worry about trying to make a difference during this time, I guarantee you God will push you forward during this time, this season. Like I created the show for a reason. I want to make a difference, not only to bring you the word of God, but some good news, some tips, tools, and some strategies and encouraging word to keep you pushing forward, moving forward in this tragic time. I love you. God bless you. I will see you all the next time on the Good News Show. Listen, stay safe, and take care of yourself. I love you. Good night.